Welcome back to the channel. My name is John. I'm a professional EAFC coach. If you want to get your gameplay analyzed, make sure you guys send it to me. Come by twitch.tv/JohnSims, and I am breaking down gameplay, especially with low viewership right now. We're going to be taking a lot of time helping you guys out. So if you want free coaching advice, come by twitch.tv/JohnSims. I'm a professional EAFC coach. I probably already said that. And today we've got elite gameplay analysis. If you want to improve your decision-making, this is how you get better. This is actually me coaching, essentially breaking down my gameplay and how I can improve and what I can do. So stick around, hang out. There's a lot of concepts. Don't miss a moment of it. We're going to be dropping a lot of content just like this. So if you see in this moment right here, he's wanting me, everything's a mind game. So what he wants to do is he wants to break this edge. So you see how Cafu is up on the edge right here? He wants to break that edge. So right away, I'm going to take out the interior lane. And then I'm going to just drive to the edge. I'm not going to settle to use my fullback. Because if I go fullback to fullback, then what happens if they break that fullback, then I'm pretty much toast. But if I can win with the winger and play the ball back to the fullback, and then I can break them early, that gives me a clinical advantage right away. So let's see if he pulls that pressure, and that's what we're doing. And then we're just driving that spot and just baiting him right into it. So we bait him into that position. Now we're waiting. He plays very good defense, and I'm just waiting to hit that run. He closes down the over-the-top ball really early. Don't want to force it. Still create the option angle in there. Wait for the play, and it just opens up for us. I'm thinking he's moving the keeper this way. I use this power shot cancel. So I use a power shot usually right here because it gives me more time to animate. And it gives me more time to see where they're going to go. So I try to adjust. However, he didn't even move his keeper. And so we have to go on the outside here. So wait for it. Here comes the corner. And I double tap and I miss. But we should already have a goal on this guy. But we just made a clinical error. Quick switching here. I'm a little bit... Oh, and he just beats me here. How did he do this? I want to see this because... So the timing's just impeccable. This is what I call the whoosh effect. So what I'm trying to do is I'm actually trying to get to my fullback here, and it switches. You can see how my movement's going downward. When you see movement like this, that means that I'm actually trying to be here. So I miss switch, and so then I go backwards, and now I'm all jangled up. And so it threw me off. And so this is what I call the whoosh effect. And it's the most powerful thing is when two objects are going towards each other. And then once they break this point, it's almost like within a millisecond, you can create that much separation within a millisecond. So right here's the break and then boom. And so you can see all that space instantly. So that's called the whoosh effect. But he takes that angle. I'm just playing, baiting, and I step, and he somehow wins it, and we barely get this tackle through. So this is just by being quicker to the punch. So that step, him winning this ball in this position is RNG. So by the ball, the placement of this technically is leaning towards me. However, since he's got whatever Mbappe that is, probably the team of the year one. I think it's the team of the year one, and... He's able to win that, and so I barely get that cheeky there. So if I'm playing a pro in this scenario, if like I'm playing an Anders kid, there may be an animation cancel here to where this comes out faster. So just keep it in the mind. So this could most likely, against a higher opponent, be a place where I would get scored on. We were pretty quick with it. Then we break that play, hold him down on the edge here. So this is a timing thing. You could probably say, John, you could just pass it here. I definitely could. But something I try to do is I try to create just a little bit more space. Because the longer I can hold him here, the longer I can manage his body position staying flat. So the shorter time frame it gets to there, the more distance I can have in the back end, giving me a higher advantage. So we just do it. We hold on as long as we possibly can. Get Zidane on the edge. Take him wide. Fake. Do a little sprint out. Here's my patented touch signature creative run outward against that new Bissek. So I probably should have just laid this ball off. I really probably just should have laid this ball off. But this Bissek card is so, it's just the most dominating card right now. That I went for it, and we were able to get a pin off him, so that's pretty tough right now. But our patented signature run here, I want to show you this. So right here, this is what I call the stop and go. This is a fundamental thing that you need to know. This is what I call the stop and go. It's the most fundamental thing in FIFA in this game to beat your opponents. So all you want to do is take this edge here, and then right when you get to a position here, you're just going to fake, act like you're going to be running inward, and instead we're doing that L1 sprint, and then we're going to break. And you see I move a little bit in. I move just slightly in, and bang, and then we hit. And so that forces him to commit. So we manipulated him into committing that position, and then now that creates this attacking angle where I can take an inseam position right away with that strong touch, and then patented backhand, backwards creative run against Bissek to create the pin. That is by far my favorite move in the game. Okay, let's see here. So here we go. Pin. Bang. Easy enough. So here we go. I've played this guy several times. This guy's about 30. He's probably as old as I am. Here we go. And he's switching here. I was a little late till the player switches, so we stay on the interior. But he's going to take that edge. He's going to keep going. I think he crosses it here. He just whips it. And he whips it. Usually players don't whip the ball like this. It's the dumbest. It's probably one of the dumbest things you can probably do is just whip the ball like that when you have a ball man on you. But with the Drogba, this is kind of a meta, is where they whip it in and then they cheek it back and hit. I was prepared for it. Barely prepared for it. The second I saw the ball go down, I had that quick switch. I have manual switching on. That does make a difference. If you use air balls, then that could be luck. But manual switching. I use manual switching. So we had to manually switch to that. Then we have to play very slow. This is what I call a breakpoint. This is the most important part of the game. If you guys are struggling with conceding late goals, conceding goals that you're like, ugh, that's such a FIFA goal, right? This is why I call a breakpoint. And a breakpoint is a scenario is when something like this happens, there's a toss up in the air and the defense is starting to create an opportunity. This is what I call a breakpoint. A breakpoint is a scenario when you get 100% success rate coming off of a 50-50 ball. So right now, we're not necessarily in a break point. We're still in a pressured scenario. If the ball somehow is able to release out here, it creates a break point. It's a big difference. What I mean by this is it's like solving the first layer of a Rubik's Cube. There's a million ways to do it, but in the end, we're all trying to solve the same problem, right? This guy could go right or he could go left. And I have to go backwards to see where he's going to go first, and then we cut the other way or vice versa. And the whole point of this is to get out of the pressure scenario. So I'm just managing that position, and we turn. I am not forcing the ball right here. This is huge. So many players will get the ball, and right away, what they'll do is they'll get this ball, and then they'll just shoot the ball out. Sometimes that can be effective on a counterattack late stage. In the mindset of the game theory, the idea is that if you're winning the game, you don't necessarily need to be aggressive. Why be aggressive in an attacking scenario like this? So what we do is we passively play this ball out against an attacker, and then we play smooth, wait for him to commit, and there we go. Now we're playing up the pitch. Now we have the advantage. Wait for him. He breaks on the line. We get on the edge here, and here it is again. Step over fake. And so this time, I was trying to attack his angle. So this time, what I was trying to do is I was actually trying to play a mind game, thinking that I'm actually not going to go inside this time and that I'm going to do the same thing and cut. So what I did is these step overs, trying to delay him, thinking that I'm going to do a step over downward and I'm going to cut up. And so I tried to get him, but he just timed it right. Anyways, he makes a poor play. And so this is an example of a bad break point. He had an opportunity. He could have just, he probably should have just dribble this ball out, right? And he plays it back, plays into attacking position. I ball roll, and I try to be cheeky on him. Again, he plays bad defense, and so my read's bad because of his bad defense. So that ball roll, I'm expecting him to read the ball roll at this skill level. I'm expecting him to read the ball roll, and so I cut back and then I rip. Okay, so this is where different levels will create different scenarios. I want to explain this to you right now. If you do not take 50-50 chances aggressively, you will never win in this game. You have to take opportunities like this. This is where I'm going at the player. I'm going at him. And I'm trying to play a mind game. You go left, I go right. I go right, you go left. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to manipulate him to do something. And so we faked, but the problem is he was too slow to respond to it. So he was too slow to it, but that was a goal scoring opportunity. So technically, if we're talking about it in opportunities right now, it's really like 3-1 in opportunities if you consider his cross. So here we go. So we win the ball in the midfield, passively wait, turn. Here's that kind of that break point. And we probably should have played this ball right here, but it was just a little too heavy and I didn't play it. And I probably should have turned this way, but I'm expecting that movement, so I didn't. And so this is just really cheap. And he's just spamming with that 95 Mia Hamm. So he's over the top ball, poor play. Force him wide, perfect. So we play him wide, cut on the inside. There we go. And so we just did the same thing. But again, this is where playing a better player, what they're going to do in this scenario is they're going to do that directional nutmeg pass. So it's going to create like a little weird angle there, and it's going to get right, bing, bing, and they'll hit that pass. And then they'll go boom, boom, and they'll do it again, and then they'll rip. So against a pro, I get scored on again. So right now we're really looking at it as like 3-2. And so this is also something, if you guys are having trouble with pressure, what you want to do is you want to create that moment of manipulation. So once I kick my leg, that manipulates him into committing his position. And so he commits, and then I read it, and then we can break off of that. So that's what we do. You want to do those fakes to create that position. Now we've got plenty of time. I can play the ball back to Bacha, and we're just going to see what happens. I play it pretty aggressive there. And we play. Now we're just going to wait for that space to open up. Now I'm playing a very aggressive position. Didn't need to do that. That was just me being dumb. That was just me forcing something I didn't need to force. And now we're on the heels, and we step into a bad shot. So if that was just a bad, that was a 1,000% just the wrong thing to do. We try to take it wide. That team of your Bellingham. There's aggressive again. So we're on a corner kick. Here we go. Patience. And then there's the flick. Fake. Now we're going to hold up play. Wait for it. Yep, there it is. Just a little bit slow in Zidane. Just a little bit slow, and I did the wrong move. Just a little bit slow in Zidane. This is where I need to upgrade my team. So I do need to upgrade my team. A couple players just by speed are a little bit too slow, like Hullet and like Buo. And there again, there's Hullet opening up. I didn't need to break this too much. So right here, I go down. I'm playing aggressive here. I'm actually faking. So if you actually look at this, I'm actually faking my position. I'm trying to get him to pass the ball here. Instead, he passes it here, which is a smart thing. Now, I don't think I make that mistake again because I don't like that back heel pass. So now we're just playing. Okay, so this time, I'm anticipating his movement to come out wide. So I'm actually trying to give, I'm trying to like bait him on the inside. Like I'm trying to bait him to push him this way. And he actually goes inside, then he plays that ball inside, and he misses, he red times. So I get a little lucky again, being a little bit over-aggressive. So I get a little lucky, and we're getting a little lucky. But there's thought behind, you know, everything that we're doing here. So here, now we're on a create a 2v1 scenario, call him back, 1-2, wait for him, and then we split open his center back, ball roll there, and then, remember the first time we didn't finish with this, this time we did finish. So let me show you something that is a little cheeky little thing you guys can do when playing the ball out of the back. You can get the ball once we break that fullback. Once the fullback commits to us this lane, all we need to do is get him to somehow commit and create that overlapping run. Overlapping run commends. Now what I've got is a 2v1 scenario. This 2v1 scenario creates, he's going to mark one. Now all I want to do is get him to commit to one. If he commits here, I can take him as wide as possible. He's going to have to open up at some point. And so what's going to happen is he's going to start to commit once he goes offside. So I call him back right after he goes offsides. Now he's concerned. So now he's thinking, okay, Eusebio or Bacha, I'm going to go Eusebio. So then he sees us going wide, and he doesn't see that inner seam with Bacha, or with Baba Jide, and then just a nice little simple layoff. So the real finesse is really manipulating that center back position for a bad read. So we just... It's against really good defenders. They may catch up on that. But if they're not, if they don't succumb to the animation or the manipulation, this is where he's just using Team of the Year Bellingham. And this is where if I have a better player, I'm winning this right now. So I shouldn't even be in this battle. I'm holding down that tackle button. Here we go. Patience. 1-2. There's a little step and fake. Barely cheeked by there. And my thing is, I'm just not anticipating this bad of defense. Really. I'm just really not anticipating this bad of defense. I'm just not expecting it to be that bad. And so that's where that comes down. Right here, I'll explain here in a second. We get that. Did we win it? Yes. Okay. So this is kind of a cheeky little position. So we get caught up. My left back's all the way out. So what I do right now is I get him into a position. This is what I call position replacement. So my CDM is going to be rotating down to like a center back and then also defending the interior while he's going to rotate and hold down that left back. Meanwhile, I'm going to have to pull this down. And so what happens is I actually fake this pressure to force that long pass. And so the idea is that I'm actually eliminating the interior threat by applying that pressure. And so now if you actually look at it, what I just showed you was my CDM was right there. And so now we're back into essentially the same scenario, except for I've eliminated two players. So I almost gambit. So what I did is I created a gambit. I gambited one CDM for two players. It's a very tricky scenario. And then he rotates and turns. And so that's what we have to beat him to, and we just barely get in and overload with that Bacha there. So there's Baba Jide's fantastic card. Wait for the close. He misses, and I just try to force it. Don't need to force that. This is where I need to really improve is right here is this decision-making right here. First off, I probably could have just held this for half a second longer. I could have just held that and then shot it just a little bit early, but right here I don't need to do that. I need to just play this ball this way and then approach and attack and then recalculate the attack. There we go. I force it again. There I am again, just trying to force it into a position it doesn't need to be. So I've caught myself forcing the ball about three or four times in this round. We're offset right here, so we're defending interior. There's that double one R1 right in perfect timing. So this is a scenario. So right here, I really should be sitting down and then letting him take that edge to then create that opening and drag down. We commit a little early. Wasn't expecting him to commit that perfect of timing. But right here is where the real magic happens is I'm staying flat, and I'm waiting for the last second to block that shot so we can guard the interior runs while calling those double players over. So that's perfect. Double R1 to do that mechanic. You also can see you guys can see my mechanics up in the top right-hand screen if you want to see all the gameplay, gamepad stuff. But okay, here we are. There it is. Win. And again, very aggressive, trying to get him to commit there, and he does. He drags all the way out, which somehow he still tackles me, even though I'm technical dribbling away from him. And this is where I actually have a problem with the game. It's so absurd. I'm able to dribble all the way out, and then somehow he's still able to get there. But whatever works, it works. But here's an example of it looks like I'm going to be committing here, and initially, and then I just break out. And so that's me faking my position again to manipulate the pass to over-anticipate. So here we go again. And so that's how this play should be when players are that aggressive. Just try to push it in. And there's a little bit of a glitch, but we win a corner off of his I guess, issue, right? So here we go, coming on in. I'm just trying to wait for that opening, and he just doesn't come into it. This is where it's really frustrating is I take... like, man, do this Mia Hamm card. And so if I have a faster player, there's no chance. And so I hate corner kicks. I absolutely hate free kicks. I hate set pieces because all your AI just gets jumbled around. Like, why isn't Bullet, like, sitting right here, and I only have, like, two? So it's, anyways, that Mia Hamm card's ridiculous. I mean, it's absurd. But anyways, so if I have a faster Hullet, that's not, there's no chance. Waiting for that play, it just doesn't cheekily. I try to even use a precision there. Drag down. Bang. We take the risk with an overlapping fullback. So this is where I'm playing too quick. Too quick. Didn't need to do it. Didn't need to do it at all. Just way too fast. Watch the switch. Ready for the switch. See how fast that is? Ready, already pressing him before he even recovers the ball. But again, he makes the wrong mistake. He should have another goal here. This is pro player switching, being ready for that switch. But right here, I don't need to commit to this. I need to act like I'm going to commit, and then I need to disengage, and I need to go right here because of how far hole it is. Again, hole it very, very slow for me. So he needs to get back. So I step, and I definitely shouldn't have done that. So now we need to drag down. What happens with this is Hullet was slow to the rotation over. So with Hullet being slow to the rotation over, that gets Buoginio, Luigi, over to commit, which then thus creates this opening and just allows him to just simply touch pass to his team of the year, Mbappe, in which he doesn't press shoot. So there we go again, trying to win that. We do into a break point. So he didn't have a break point, and then there it is. 1-2, and the ball pass didn't go the way I wanted it, and so we just finished it off there. So in the second half, guys, it's kind of the same, and he ends up I think he ends up passing the ball like out of bounds by himself. I get like a pen, and it's a bad pen, but I win. It was just terrible, but we ended up winning that. He rage quit. He's about an 800 SR player, but this is the type of content that's really going to improve your game, is seeing how we think and how to implement this. If you have questions on type of gameplay, come down to twitch.tv/SonicSims, and I'll analyze your gameplay and give you guys any feedback you need to get better at this game. You guys can also sign up for a private coaching session on metafy.gg/@JohnSims, and that's links in the bio, and we'll see you guys soon.